watching CN2 News, your number one source for award-winning hometown coverage.
Animal abuse, always heartbreaking, and now one tragic story has animal activists asking for stricter enforcement.
Plus, a string of armed robberies in one county. How deputies are hoping surveillance video will help you help them catch those criminals.
And showing those in the community the Christmas spirit. We will have just who these stockings are being delivered to next. Your news starts now. Good evening, I'm Renee O'Neill. Lucas will join us a little later in the show.
I'm Laura Bree Monday. Thanks for joining us tonight. First up, tis the season for criminals to get busy, but fortunately, surveillance video is a real gift to law enforcement. The York County Sheriff's Office is investigating several armed robberies in the county and is asking for your help. There is some good surveillance video, so take a look. The first, December 8th, it happened at the Catawba Express on Highway 5 near Catawba. According to the Sheriff's Office, the suspect is a black man who wore a mask with one eye hole cut out, a gray hoodie, and camo pants. He was armed with a silver handgun and demanded money. The second one, take a look, happening at the Kangaroo Express. This is in Fort Mill. The suspects entered the store and pulled out a gun. Then the suspect drove off in a gold Mercury Marquis. And the most recent crime, just yesterday, Wednesday, December 13th, it happened at the Waffle House. This is pretty dramatic. There in Regent Parkway in Fort Mill, deputies say a trio sat down, actually ordered food, and while the cook prepared it, they got up, jumped over the counter, and robbed the restaurant at gunpoint, even making people get to the ground. The suspects left in a silver or gold Ford Crown, Victoria, or a Mercury Marquis. Again, if you have any information about these armed robberies, call Crime Stoppers, the number there on your screen. Four Rock Hill students transported with minor injuries after a wreck involving their school bus. Rock Hill Schools tweeting this photo this afternoon saying the accident scene was at Highway 5 and Highway 901. Again, it was this Thursday afternoon. The wreck involved two cars and the bus. Again, only minor injuries.
The owner of a horse in Lancaster is offering a reward after deputies say the horse was shot. According to the Lancaster County Sheriff's Office, a deputy was dispatched to a home on Old Church Road on November 18th. Earlier that morning, the owners found their horse, Boss, dead from an apparent gunshot wound to the head. They are offering a $1,000 reward for information leading to whoever is responsible for the horse's death. If you have any information, please call the number on your screen.
An animal advocacy group is calling for stricter enforcement on animal abuse cases so more animals, specifically in this case dogs, aren't hurt or killed in York County.
And last week, we introduced you to an 18-month-old pit bull lab mixed named Briggs. This was so sad. Briggs was found tied to a tree with his tongue cut out a few weeks ago in York.
He was in 24-hour ICU care for several weeks, but this week he passed away from his injuries. Our news partner, WBTV's Christy O'Connor, with more on the story. And if police believe Briggs was a victim of dogfighting.
This particular story really breaks my heart, and it's right in that area where Briggs was found.
Sarge Douglas is a passionate animal advocate in York County.
What I'm going to show you now is graphic.
She could go on and on about disturbing stories.
And he was barely alive. He was laying on top of many other dog carcasses.
All involving animals she's seen in her area. She and other members of their Committee for Responsible Pet Ownership have walked down the block handing out doghouses, straw, and food to animals who appear to be neglected.
If we're seeing it, so is anybody that's a potential employer wanting to move a company here or a potential resident that wants to move to this area. They can just drive around and see these cases and look and say, this is representative of York County. Is this what we really want them to see?
Compliance with animal ordinances is regulated by code enforcement, but with just two men in the unit, they say they can't patrol as often as they'd like to.
Unfortunately, due to manpower, a lot of times we are complaint based.
And aside from manpower, dog fighting cases can be even trickier.
It is an underground sport, so it's not like you're not going to walk up to the Walmart and see it.
To infiltrate these tight-knit groups, they almost need to know exact times and locations to make an arrest.
We kind of know or feel that they are fighting these dogs, but unless you catch them in the act of the actual fight, that's what's hard to prove.
Again, that was Christy O'Connor with WBTV News. She also adds there are some warning signs to look for that could indicate dog fighting. Someone having multiple dogs, typically pit bulls, and they will be likely chained. Also, if cars are coming in and out of a specific location, either a home or a secluded area at very specific times.
And York police still haven't made an arrest in Briggs' case. They've tracked down the original owner from the chip found in the dog, but haven't found the most recent owners Briggs was with when he was abused. And while investigators don't say dog fighting is exactly prevalent in York County, it could be going on more often than we think. Well, a new company is coming to York County and is bringing 500 jobs with it. Stanley Black & Decker says it's opening a new manufacturing facility in the Lakemont Business Park in Fort Mill. Stanley Black & Decker is one of the world's largest tool and storage companies. The new operation will bring a $31 million capital investment, and the company will be constructing a new 345,000 square foot facility. Just visit the company's website if you would like to learn more.
York County teachers getting a chance to shop for free to buy some books for their classroom. 40,000 books were donated to schools in both Mecklenburg and York counties, and the public schools specifically. Domtar to thank for this, along with the nonprofit First Book, donating those thousands of books. It's to Classroom Central in Charlotte, and our York County teachers went up to do their shopping. Teachers came in and left with carts full of books that will then go into the hands of students so they can inspire them and build their education. CN2 speaking with representatives of Domtar, and they say it's important to make sure everyone has books to read.
For Domtar, literacy is really important to us, and we feel like putting books into the hands of children really equips them to learn. And to be able to do that with our local nonprofit, it's really an impactful way to positively work with the community.
Many of the books came straight from publishers to help get children on the right path to success.
While handing out Christmas stockings to people that need them the most, the Comporium Pioneers delivering Christmas stockings to the Adult Enrichment Center today, filled to the brim with all kinds of goodies and personal care items. Most of the clients at the center have disabilities, which prevent them from taking care of themselves, so getting these stockings is definitely a blessing. The Pioneers took time to put much love into these stockings, and it looks like this love will go a long way.
It's great for our clients, and it's great for the staff because it's very heartwarming. The staff do a lot for our clients every day, and it's so nice to see that members of the community are stepping up and doing some things for our clients as well. It's really heartwarming.
The stockings will be handed out to the clients of the center during a special breakfast on Friday. Well, here's our latest Airpoint Federal Credit Union picture of the day. Harvey Mayfield and his friends, who sew those beautiful quilts for veterans, stopping by CN2 today to spread some Christmas cheer. They brought many homemade goodies with them. Thank you guys so much. We promise those will not go to waste.
Delicious, and thanks again. And want to see your photo as picture of the day? Email it to news@cn2.com. Coming up here on CN2 News.
It's beginning to smell a lot like Christmas, and that's because of all these gingerbread houses. I'm CN2's Alexandria Savage speaking with students about what it took to make these houses look so special.
We will have fun. We will be enthusiastic. We will play with energy unmatched.
Fort Mill High School football players meeting the new head football coach. We hear from him a little later in sports. Welcome back to CN2 News, building more than just houses, but relationships.
Rock Hill students at the Applied Technology Center are getting in the holiday spirit with a sweet treat. CN2's Alexandria Savage speaking with students about their fresh take on Christmas.
The Introduction to Teaching program allows high school students to learn how to become teachers by working with 4K students all semester. And now together they are building their dream homes one gingerbread wall at a time.
She's very quiet and very shy, but she loves to do hands-on work and stuff like that. And she loves icing a lot. I figured that out today.
Each high school student finds their own special way to make sure their students' experience is enjoyable, educational, and in this case, tasty.
It was a lot of fun, you know. It takes skill because it was pretty hard, but it was fun. It was real fun.
And students in each level agree building each house takes not only time but also skill.
When you add the top of the house, that's the hardest part because it won't stay sometimes.
The hardest part to put it on the icing on because because it was falling down.
It was very strong, so knowing that I was strong, you could be a little bit harder when putting things together.
It took students and their 4K buddies 2 days to build and decorate these houses. The gingerbread is hand-cut and the icing is homemade. Now, they say it's definitely getting them into the Christmas spirit.
I love Christmas. Yeah, I decorate a lot.
Veterans used past experiences to help them succeed.
You build out cran crackers. And you build it with, you put the icing and you put it under the icing.
High schoolers also say they've learned from their little buddies and working with them makes things easier.
It's so much easier. Now I know to add more icing and it's okay to let them help sometimes.
Building their knowledge base, confidence, and a sweet holiday treat. In Rock Hill, Alexandria Savage, CN2 News.
Well, early childhood education is a 2-year program that helps prepare college-bound students planning to pursue a degree in education. During the program, the hands-on class explores strategies of teaching and gets to the high school students to interact with young children while completing educational activities.
I'd say that's a fun way to learn if you like your job or not. I bet they do. Well, here's your CN2 forecast. Looks like sunny days ahead for Friday and Saturday. Highs of 49 tomorrow, lows reaching 27. We could see some rain on Sunday, but as of now, only a 10% chance.
And in tonight's digital dashboard, our news partners and friends over at WRHI celebrating their 73rd birthday this Thursday. The station signed on for the first time on December 14th in 1944.
And hundreds of families in our community receiving gifts from the Salvation Army this Thursday at its distribution center. Those with the Salvation Army say it's the community who donated that they want to thank. Our cameras were there, and we'll have a full story in Friday's show.
Well, next on CN2 News, Lucas sits down with those in our area who make it their goal to keep York County beautiful. We'll be right back after this.
Welcome back to CN2 News. We are talking about cleaning up our community. I want you to meet Allison Woodruff. And Allison, you are the Clean Community Coordinator for York County. Thank you so much for joining us. The job title is simple enough, but kind of tell folks a little bit about more about what you do in your role in York County.
I will. We are in the umbrella of York County Collection and Recycling. So the Keep York County Beautiful affiliate is underneath that, as part of that. The board is comprised of volunteer members, and I'm the staff liaison. So we have those that are representative of the council districts and the at-large, and they help us with events, and we work to protect waterways and landscapes in the community, whether it's through litter reduction, eradication, recycling, waste reduction, beautification efforts, and education and PR when we can.
I'm shocked that people still litter. I still see litter. I try to pick it up when we can, and there's a trash can nearby. Is it still an ongoing issue as it has been years before when there was the big anti-litter campaign?
I think that we have reached a plateau with that, kind of like sometimes it happens in recycling because everybody thinks it's already fixed and it's done when there's a lot more work to do. I think that unsecured loads, when people are taking things to one of the collection recycling centers or just hauling in general, having that unsecured makes a big difference. And that is the biggest source of litter in the county and in the state. You do have people throwing things out the window still. Foot traffic also is a problem, but unsecured loads is huge. And it is illegal state and countywide, but there's just not enough ways to enforce it. And we are not an enforcement body, obviously. So we try to get the word out in other ways and have volunteer pickup programs.
Well, speaking of volunteers, I understand there's a need for volunteers, and they can be involved in various ways. And talk about that.
Absolutely. It doesn't have to be that you have to come to a board meeting or even any meetings. You know, if you want to only communicate, for those of us who are sometimes introverted, email is great. You know, if you want to do it on social media, we'd like for people to share our posts. There's York County Recycling and then Keep York County Beautiful. We have Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. So it's easy that we have a website that's being updated. So currently we're still in our older one, but that will be updated and be easier to use. We just want people to spread the word because our events are all free. They're public. We have America Recycles Day coming up in November. Okay. And so we'll have a shredding event and a compost bin sale, and then we have activities for children as well, and all of that will be on there. But we just want people to help spread the word.
And they get plugged in wherever their best personality and their best skills are
yes,
set.
Yes, absolutely.
Another big volunteer needed, volunteers are needed for grant writing.
We have grants that we offer. They're $500 in the form of Lowe's gift cards. Okay. And since 2014, we have offered these to community members, schools, businesses. It doesn't matter who you are. We just have a few things that we would like for people to focus on, whether it's litter eradication, recycling. We have a big focus right now on pollinators because obviously that's an issue, and we get a little bit more focus on those if people send in an application that involves pollinator habitats. So we will offer those to people again this fall. Okay. The cycle's open now. We had one in the spring. And for anybody who wants to do that, they send the application in to me. It can be found on the website, or they can email me. But it's a great opportunity, and we funded even the same entity multiple years in a row. If we see a progression, there's a long-term project. Schools have been involved with this. It's really great, but it's hard to get the word out.
Okay. Another thing, too, we're trying to get the word out is about college scholarships.
Yes. We offer a college scholarship, also in the form of $500, and it's just a check. And we get that through grant funding, and then we offer it to the community. Mm-hmm. We've had a high school person from, he was at South Point, okay, and he received that this year, but we haven't had any applications in for the college scholarship. And it's easy. We're asking just for someone to come up with a social media, for Instagram, a short video, and then a longer video that could go to YouTube about Keep York County Beautiful and Keep South Carolina Beautiful and the pride that we all feel. Mm-hmm. And make that be viral. And it's a little bit harder when it's happy stuff to get the word out.
So the best piece of advice for folks, if they want to learn more about keeping York County clean, what's the website we need to visit?
yorkcountygov.com/KYCB.
Awesome. All right, Allison Woodruff, thank you so much for keeping York County looking her best. We certainly appreciate it.
Thank you.
And thank you so much for joining us. We'll be back with more right after this.
This is CN2 Sports. There is a new Fort Mill head football coach.
We will meet him in just a moment. But first, the South Point Stallions head football coach is one of the six finalists for the 2017 U.S. Army All-American High School Football Coach of the Year. Coach Heron led his team to a fourth straight 4A football state championship earlier this month. The winner of the U.S. Army All-American High School Football Coach of the Year will be announced on Friday, January 5th, which is the day before the annual game. It will be played in San Antonio.
And the annual 81st Shrine Bowl of the Carolinas will be this Saturday at Wofford College at 2 p.m. The Shrine Bowl picks the top players from North and South Carolina to compete. Four high schoolers from our area will be playing in the game. Two are from South Point, one from Northwestern, and one from York.
Well, new beginnings at Fort Mill High School as it's now hired new football coach. CN2 Danielle DeTomo spoke with him about his goals for the Fort Mill football program.
It is an exciting day here at Fort Mill High School because they have a new football coach. I'm standing here with Coach McNeely. So, Coach, let's just talk a little bit about your background coaching football. Where did you come from?
I spent the first 5 years of my career at West Idaho High School as a position coach. Joined the Lake Norman community in 2002 as a new school. Was the defense coordinator until 2009, took over after that season as a head coach.
All right, so tell me now, what brought you to Fort Mill High School?
Was not really looking to make a lateral move in North Carolina, and that was what I I've been fortunate enough to, blessed to be at Lake Norman, so everything I thought would be a lateral move to move within the state. And this opportunity opened up. It's a great school system, a lot of rich tradition, both academically and athletically, and I'm ready to dive in.
And Coach McNeely was just in the gym talking to his future team. He gave them just an inspiring speech about what to look forward to. Just talk about what your goals are here at Fort Mill for their football team.
First of all, we want to deserve the win. You know, and that, obviously that's not going to happen every game, but the work we put in the offseason and Saturday through Thursday better be to gain an advantage on the field on Friday night. Like I said, you're not going to win every game, but if you can look yourself in the mirror and say that you did everything you could to win, then that's a goal of mine.
Okay, so we want to thank Coach McNeely for speaking with us today. We certainly look forward to Friday night's coming up next football season. That will do it for CN2 Sports.
Thanks, Danielle, and make sure you tune in tomorrow night again. We will be bringing you the Salvation Army as they gave so many gifts away to hundreds of families in our community right here. It was really neat to see the smiles on all those families' faces.
Also, if you like cutting down a Christmas tree, TikTok, time may have run out for you. We're going to head out to Penland Farms. A lot of good stories going on. Thanks for watching, everyone.
Good night.